Members of the Uganda Bankers Association appeared before the Parliament's Finance Committee and endorsed amendments in the Microfinance Deposit Taking Institutions Amendment Bill 2022, which seeks to provide for the use of the word bank for microfinance deposit taking institutions.
Build capacity and empower these institutions so that they can provide a more range of services, but most importantly, build confidence in the mind of the customer or the depositor there. It is clear they will be called microfinance banks.
Commercial banks are saying, others, not all, they're saying once you use the word bank, it gives you a leverage. You have to step up in terms of supervision or requirements. There are benchmarks, which they are saying most of the MDIs, you don't have.
If we use the word bank, that does not mean we are not going to be depositing money with them. The activities that the partnership that we have been having with the commercial banks, it is something that is going to continue.
Microfinance operators who were part of the meeting argued that the word microfinance has got a bad reputation in the public, arising from several microfinance institutions that cheated Ugandans in the early days.
There is that word microfinance, the confidence from the public is really very low. Then also there is the aspect that we are one of the biggest customers for commercial banks, the tier one customers. We are one of their biggest customers. So despite of the fact that there may be some feeling of competition, but we are actually complementing each other.
Use of the term bank is very common. It's a welcome thing. It also, as my colleagues will speak to it, brings about confidence, especially with good regulation.
The Bankers Association justified amendments that allowing regulated microfinance institutions be called microfinance banks will build public confidence required for saving in the financial system and further financial inclusion.
Our country has the lowest savings culture in the region, and we believe that passing of this bill into law will help our microfinance depositing institutions mobilize more deposits, because right now customers come to us for the loans, but they don't keep money with us. So the question is, where is that money kept? And yet we are the ones that are able to reach the last mile in the rural areas.
Once the amendments are made, this will enable us to have confidence, and then it will also enable us to encourage the savings culture, because savings culture is a very key issue. And again, if you look at the categories of the customers we serve, these are customers who have balances less than 100,000.
Led by Wilbrod Awol, the executive director of the Uganda Bankers Association, they welcomed a provision to allow microfinance do agent banking, saying it will enhance outreach services at a lower cost and also improve public perceptions on the microfinance deposit-taking institutions.
Today, we have a total number of 26,000 agents spread across the country, from 1,000 to 26,000. By allowing MDIs do agent banking, we want to triple the number of agents to 75,000 so that we have financial services spread across the country.
The bill also offers an opportunity to microfinance deposit-taking institutions to offer other products like Islamic banking and bank assurance. According to Bankers Association, the insurance penetration, which currently stands at 0.2%, can be enhanced if microfinance institutions are allowed to do bank assurance.
MDIs who reach the lowest to popularize insurance through bank assurance, we 0.2% penetration. Current. We will increase the penetration and bring up insurance.
Story by Fred Kajibi for the news.